Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform any scenic photo into a stunning retro travel poster. Open a scenic photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. To ensure that the filter setting amounts I'll be using in this tutorial will have the same results as mine, let's check your photo's resolution. Press Alt-Control-I on Windows or Command-Option-I on a Mac. You could also go to Image and Image Size. Make sure your image is 300 pixels per inch. The first step is to convert your photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Artistic, and Cutout. Make the number of levels 8, the edge simplicity 6, and the edge fidelity 1. Go to Filter, Blur, and Smart Blur. Basically, this filter applies a blur radius to each pixel using a threshold to determine where the blur should be applied. Make the radius 63, the threshold 32, the quality high, and the mode overlay edge. Double-click the icon to the right of the Smart Blur to open this filter's blending mode. Choose Overlay. To increase its color vibrancy or saturation, click the adjustment layer icon and click Vibrance. The difference between vibrance and saturation is this. Vibrance adjusts the intensity of less saturated colors, while saturation increases the intensity of all the colors. In this instance, I'll increase the intensity of all the colors by increasing its saturation to 60. Next, I'll add stylized clouds. If you want to add clouds to the sky in your poster and hide some of them behind areas of its foreground, make your poster active and open your Quick Selection tool. Make its radius 5 pixels. Drag the tool over areas of the foreground. Make the top layer active and make a new layer above it. Alt or Option click the layer mask icon to make an inverted layer mask of the selection next to the empty layer. This will hide or mask out the cloud from appearing in front of the mountain. A simple rule to remember is this. In layer masks, white reveals and black conceals. Make the empty layer active and open the curvature pen tool. Click on your document to make the first anchor point. Release and click to make a second anchor point. Click again to make a third anchor point. Each time you make another anchor point, it continues to arc the paths. To make a sharp path, double-click an anchor point. Continue these steps until you like the shape of your cloud. If you want to adjust any of the points, press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag that point. To fill the path with a color, place your cursor directly on the path and right-click it. Click Fill Path. Open the Contents list and click White. If you want your clouds to be a different color, click Color, and when the color picker opens, click the color you want. To hide the path, press Ctrl or Command H. If you want to reposition the cloud, click off the chain link between the layer mask and the cloud layer to unlink them. Open back your Move tool. If you notice the cloud isn't moving smoothly, go to View. You'll probably see that Snap is checked. Just click it to deactivate it. To add more clouds, make a new layer and press P to open back your curvature pen tool. make a new work path, and fill the path with a color. Then hide the path. Open your Move tool and drag the cloud to a position you like. Make a new layer. In this layer, we'll start adding our text, but before we do, let's place it into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. All our text-related layers will be placed inside this folder. Let's name it Text. Make the layer active and open your Horizontal Type tool. Open the Type Picker and pick a font. For this poster, I'll be using two different fonts, one for each line of text. If you'd like to use either or both, I provided their links in my video's description. The first typeface is called American Captain Regular. I'll make its size 200 points. However, feel free to adjust its size based on the font you pick and the number of characters in your text. Make its aliasing smooth, and I'll make its alignment centered. At this point, the color in the color box is irrelevant. Click on your document and type out your text. To position it, open your Move tool and move it. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the lower text. Right-click on an empty area of the top text layer to open the flyout list and click Convert to Shape. Open your Path Selection tool and click the Fill Color box. I did an in-depth tutorial all about the Fill and Stroke feature, so if you want to watch it, I provided its link in my video's description. Click the Color Picker icon and pick a color for the face of your text. I already picked the color I want, which I typed into the hexadecimal field. Click the Stroke icon. Currently, it has a no stroke symbol. However, I want the stroke to be white, so I could either click any of the white color boxes, or I can open the color picker and pick white. Open the stroke options and the align list. I'll click the outside alignment option, which sets the stroke along the outside of the text. Open the caps option. I'll pick projecting. For corners, I'll pick the top bevels option, which creates squared corners. To adjust your stroke's thickness, drag the stroke's width to the right or left. To see the stroke better, hide the path. To center our text from side to side, press Ctrl or Command A to select our document and open the Move tool. Click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. To raise or lower it, press and hold the Shift key and the up or down arrow on your keyboard to move it up or down 10 pixels at a time. To add another line of text, just follow the same steps. Lastly, we'll add paper texture to our poster, but before we do, let's close the text folder to save some space in the Layers panel. Scroll to the bottom and shift-click the bottom layer to make all the layers active. We'll convert all of them into one smart object. Go to Filter, Texture, and Texturizer. The texture is sandstone, the relief is 3 or 4, and the scaling is 200%. I'll make the light top right, but you could make it whatever you want. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.